thank you to our collaborators and my team. So Sanjog Mangrati is also our core member, and we are actually belonging from Northeast chapter. So if you want to be part of our chapter, the link would be provided by the moderators shortly. So day four, and we will start up with JavaScript today.
I have a question for the audience. Okay, so the audience, I want to hear the responses in the chat. Are you all excited for today's event? Come on, chat. Let me hear. Are you guys excited? Okay, Ganesh, Subrani, all right, Sadia. Okay. Come on, more. Let's see.
Wow, we can see a lot of responses actually. So people are already excited about JavaScript.
Okay, then we will starting shortly. And please refrain from any negativity in the chats, please. It's a request. Only ask doubts relevant to the topic and focus on what's been taught. Okay, so now over to you, Aniket. We shall continue with JavaScript.
And before that, actually, I will request the moderators. Can you just share the link for the chapter? The moderators. Okay, so we would be Hello, sharing everyone. The link for our Northeast chapter, and then Aniket will start.
Okay. Yeah. So are you guys ready? Yes, everyone?
I sure am, Aniket. So excited.
Yes, everyone started responding. Hi, everyone. Hi. So let's take a quick revision of yesterday's lecture. Let me share my screen. I think so. Slide is visible.
Yes, Aniket.
Okay. So yesterday we have started with the JavaScript. That what is JavaScript? It is a lightweight programming language that is used to make web pages interactive, and JavaScript is usually made to react to events. And what is the history? And the most important part of the history was that it was built in 10 days. So I'm covering in a quick yesterday one. And is there any difference between Java and JavaScript? So there is nothing common between Java and JavaScript. And what is the use of console.log? Yeah, everyone knows for printing anything in the console, we use console.log. And just like here, I use console.log for printing files. And there are two types of comments in the JavaScript, single line comment and multiple line comment. So yeah, this is single line comment. And this is multiple line comment. And here I have used single line comment. And from line 3 to line 8, I have used multiple line comment. And I have told the fundamental data types in the JavaScript are number, string, boolean, null, undefined. Let's move ahead. Here I have used console.log to print different data types. These are the common arithmetic operators in the JavaScript. And then we have performed some operations using the arithmetic operators. And we can also use a plus or addition operator for string concatenation. And for printing the length or for knowing the length of a string, what we use? Come on in the chat box. Today also our target will be 2000 chats. What we use for finding the length? Yes, everyone. Yes, everyone is quite smart. The function is dot length. Wait, let me change the color of the. Yeah, now this. And find the length of the string of this, and the important part was that the length of the string also calculate the space between two strings. Then we have seen methods like dot to uppercase and trim method, and built-in objects like math. And using math, what we have done, we have find the math dot random to print the random number between 0 to 1, and for finding the random number between 0 to 50, what we need to do, we need to multiply it by 50. And here 50 is not included. Math dot floor, what does math dot floor makes the value as a whole number, because math dot random returns the value in decimal form. Number dot integer is used to check whether a number or data type what you have given input is an integer or not. So till here we have studied yesterday. Let me open my Chrome browser. Okay, what we do inspect, then we go to the console for writing our JavaScript. So yesterday I have told, if we want to write anything in the console, what we do, we write console.log hello, then it will print hello. But if you want to use some, like I can say, HTML tags in your page using JavaScript, then what you can do, this I have told yesterday, inside the document.write, you need to add your tag like document dot write hello, and see, it is printed on the screen. So whatever we'll write inside our tag, that will inside our tag or inside the document.write, that will be printed on our screen. So just like document.write, I'm writing it. So first of all, I'm changing my line. And now line has been changed. Now I am writing document.write as to I. Now what it will print and where? The main question is where it will print. Yes, in the chat box, in the console or in the screen. Yes, everyone respond in the chat box. Screen. Yes, correct. On the screen it will be printed. Yes. Then if anybody can tell that when I have printed it, let me try one more. Then I will ask you a question. So have you noticed that when I am writing hi after hello, then space is means you can say it is single line space. But here we can see maybe double line space is leaving. Why it is happening here? Yes, in the chat box. Yes, Rudrash. Yes, Jaydeep. Yes, Vinod. Yes. Oh, guys, you guys noticed that I have used VR. I thought you will not notice. That's nice. Okay, I think so. We should move ahead with the today topics more. Mm-hmm. Let me share my PPT.
Yep.
So we will start with what are variables. Today, our today's first topic will be variables. In programming, a variable is a container for a value. You can think of variables as little container for information that live in a computer's memory. Information stored in a variable can be such as your username, your roll number, or either can be a Boolean value. So you can think, Yeah. You can think variable as a container or box where you can store any important thing like name, roll number, or like fruit name or anything. Or you can store even a Boolean value, true or false, even a value or a string. So for declaring a variable, so the now the concept comes like, we know that we can store inside a variable anything, but how to store or keep the things inside this container? So for using that, we need to use a keyword var, and this will be the variable name, and this can be anything. Here I can use even x also, where x is equal to an. And then we have printed the variable name, and the output, it has given us the array, the name of the variable. But the latest version of declaring the variable is not where. Now we used to declare variables as let and using const. We use const for the constant values and let for that the values that can be changed with time. So wait, let me show you one example. So where favorite food, it's pizza, where number of slices, it's 8, and then we in the console.log we have printed favorite food, so it has printed us pizza. Then we have printed the number of slices, then it has printed 8. But now this is the old concept of using it where, but the now the latest thing to use or declare the variables in the JavaScript is using let. So if I will write let x is equal to 22 and console.log x, what will be the output here? Yes, chat box. Okay, yes, everyone is responding. 22. Yes, correct, everyone. 22 will be the answer. Now, what we have done, I have declared here the integer part. But if, okay, let me bring your change. If below this line, I will use console.log x plus 1. What it will print? 23, everyone is typing. Okay. You guys are too smart. Let me do something difficult. Okay. My new question will be, let y is equal to, let me take integer 20 and console dot log y plus 320, then it will print 23. Wait, tell your answers in the chat box. Yes, 20. Answer will be 203 only, not 23. Why the answer will not be 23? Because this is a string, and this is a string, and we are using between two strings a operand, a addition operand. So here, what is happening? A string concatenation. Let's move ahead with the window alert method. What is window alert method? So like sometimes you have seen that in your website, some alert box is coming that this website is using your location or maybe allow location or blog or like okay anything. This website is using cookies, then some box appears and what you need to do? You need to click here, okay. So for making that box, what we can do, we can write alert and inside the alert box or alert parenthesis, that will be printed in your alert box. We will see it practically later. After two or three slides, we will see it practically. So alert box is looked something like this. Now, what is prompt box? We have seen alert box is used to show you an alert. And what you need to do? You need to click only OK there. But in the prompt box, it is not only for clicking the OK. In the prompt box, looks like this. Here will be your string, whatever you will write inside the prompt statement. And then there will be one input box. And then OK or cancel. So prompt box is used if you want the user to input a value. So if you want to take a input a value from the user, we use prompt box. And if you want to show the alert to a user, then we use alert box. So yeah. Alert box looks something like this, like here can be a number, enter a value of X, and whatever you will enter, then you need to print here. Then you need to click here, OK. And next thing will be, OK, one, let me ask you. Wait, I'm asking you a random question. What is the, tell me the application of mat.random. Means what is the application you have seen in your real life or in your apps somewhere or anywhere if you have seen? Tell me the applications of mat.random in the chat. To generate random number. Anybody else? Yeah, that I know that it will print a random number from. Yes, now everybody started giving some right answers. If let me take their name. Keshav and Ikraj. Number guys, game, Halo game. Yeah, mainly the most use of application of mat.random you can see in the games and the real life. I can say the game which you have played too much in your mobiles or maybe in your system or in real life, that is Ludo dice. What you need to do, you need to print a random number between 1 to 6. So the application of map.random can be used in making or developing a Ludo game, or we can say Ludo dice specifically. Now we'll move ahead with the loops. What are loops? In computer science, a loop is a programming structure that repeats a sequence of instructions until a specific condition is met. So like you need to print different things or different numbers till a specific condition met. Like in the while condition, using the while loop. So there are many types of loop, while, for, and do while. You must have studied in other programming languages too. So like for I is less than equal to 10, and I have declared I value is 5. And inside the parenthesis, what I'm doing? Console.log I. Give me the output, what it will print. Yes, come on in the chat box. Okay, wait. You all are, yes, Adit, you are only correct, I know. And now Monil Gandhi is also correct. So yeah, it will not print, means most of you guys have answered me that it will print 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and some of you answered me 5, 5, 5, 10, and the only few, two or three people answered me that it will run infinite loop. That is correct. It will be an infinite loop that will print 5, 5, 5, 5, 5 till infinite. Why? Because what it will do, it is I is equal to 5. Then I am checking the condition that 5 is less than equal to 10. Yes, it is less than. Then what we are doing? Then we are printing the 5. Then it is printed the value 5. But what after that? After that, we have not incremented our value. Again, it will check whether 5 is less than equal to 10, another it will print. So this loop will keep till infinite time. But if we want to print 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, what we need to do? We need to apply here increment operator, I++. So what does I++ do? I++ increases the value by 1. I is equal to I plus 1. This is I++ is equal to I equal to I plus plus 1. So now what it will do? First, it will print 5. It will print 5 here, then it will increment the value of I. Now it will do the value of I is equal to 6. Then it will check here whether the 6 is less than equal to 10. Yes, 6 will be 6 is less than equal to 10. Then it will print console.log I. Now I value is 6. Then it will print 6. So then now the output will be 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. All of you got this loop one condition? Yes, please respond. Okay, let me show you practically then. Then alert and prompt box. Wait, I'm sharing my screen. Okay, inspect. Then we go to the console. Then we write here alert. This is my first alert box. See, an alert box appears that this is my first alert box. And for prompt, enter the value of x. enter. So now see what is asking, and the value of x. If I'll write here 45 and then if I'll click OK, then it will give us the output 45 in the console, because alert box shows us only the alert while prompt is used to take the input from the users. And let's see the variable part. Let x is equal to 5. Let y is equal to 2. Console.log plus 5. Tell me the output. Seven. Okay. Yes, right. You guys are always correct. And let me ask, let a is equal to from, enter the first number. Okay, I am entering the first number as 10. Let b is equal to 10. Console.log a plus b. No, whether it will be.
Just yes. Kiran, please stop spamming the chat. This is the last warning. Otherwise, we'll have to remove you from the meeting. Kindly don't disturb the people who are here to learn. Sorry, Aniket, you can carry on.
Okay. Okay, guys. So whether it will print a plus b, or means I have inputted the value of a using the prompt and assigned the value in the variable b as 10. So whether it will print addition of both or not. Yes, guys. Tell in the chat. Wait, now this is yes, it will print 20, but wait, let me see. Who's typing? Jasleen?
Yes, I can.
Yeah. Yeah, this Jaskreen Kodwedi. Yeah, just whoever this is, Jaskreen Kodwedi, it's your last warning. Please don't spam in the chat box. Don't write too much outputs. Only one time you need to give.
Yes,
otherwise,
sir.
if she will do later, then you can remove.
Yeah, I'll do that.
Okay, guys. Yes, input is stored. Yes, Aditya is asking, input is stored as string or integer. So here our JavaScript will decide whether the input is integer or string. But in the case of this, wait, let me show you. What we are doing here, you are entering an integer value, then it will take your value as an integer only. But if you will print a string, then it will take your value as a string. So this is not your headache in the case of JavaScript. But if you want to ensure that you only want, if you want to ensure that you only want the integer input, then what you can do, let x equal to, there's one option, and now if you will ask the same question, like let x is equal to, enter the first number. Okay, there was some missing argument, was one missing. let c is equal to parsing. So if you are sure that you want to take an integer input only, then you can use parse int before the prompt operator. But if you will not use the parse int, then it will take a string, like in this case. Here you have inputted 10, then 10 here, then 10 plus 10, like string plus integer, it has given us string. Why it is given as string plus integer is string? Because string is a large data type in the case of size. Enter the first number. So if you want 20 as an output, what you can do? 10, I'm inputting. And then let d is equal to 10. console.log c plus d. Now it will print 20. Why? Because in this case, I have taken the value input as an integer by writing this parse dot parse int before the prompt. But in this case, I haven't written an it. And the JavaScript treated it as an integer. Then integer plus, taken it as a string. String plus integer always give you a string. Why? Because a string is a large data type. In the case of size. But here for taking the integer only, we have used parse int before the prompt box. Okay. Parse stands for parsing the values in the prompt box. Okay, now let me ask the question. Prompt, enter first value, pass into, again I forgot to put that bracket, let q is equal to pass in prompt, enter first value. Yeah, now I'm entering my first value as 2 and taking the another value, let w is equal to 2 again. And now I'm using one alert box for printing. So in the alert box, what I am doing, w plus q. What it will print, alert w plus q. Jerry, I will respond to all the questions. I haven't seen now. Till then, you can tell me the answer of this. Alert W plus Q, what it will print? Pop-up box and addition of two numbers. Yes, exactly. Okay. And one pop-up box appears and it has given us the addition of two numbers. W plus Q. Now we will move ahead and we will see the loop operation. Int I is equal to 1. Wait, again I've used int here. Let I is equal to 1. I is less than equal to 10. And not console, yeah, let me write in the console. Console.log, printing the value of I. Then I is equal to I plus 2. And yes, what it will print? Come on, guys. Yeah. Think and tell the answer of this. 13579. Okay, exactly. Correct. All of you are correct. 13579. yeah, means anything we can say 13579 or numbers from between 1 to 10. Now, why it is printing 11? Anyone can tell? Actually, it is not printing 11. It is the console box output that the another next operation will be. Still, anyone want to wait? Anyone want to try why it is printing 11 here? As it is taking 10. No. Okay. You will get to know, and I will do another operation. Just look this. Let j is equal to 1, while j is less than equal to 5. Console.log j, j plus plus. Now let's see out. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And again, it has inputted a value of 5. 2 times 5. Yes, Kashish. You are somewhere correct. Yes, because I equal to 9 will still valid. Yeah, that's the right answer. Because it checks the another console is mainly used for the developers, and it checks the situation that the what next situation can be, and for the I equal to 9, which is less than 10, so it will check. Yes, all of you are correct. And the most, and now let me show you the most important part. What we will be doing. Okay, now we will be building a game. You can say a simple game which is not with full of animations, and you play in your mobiles and websites or any online games. It is not like that. It will be a simple game. And the game name will be Guess the Number. And what we will do with the game means what the commands and what the operations we will use in our games. That is only the limited operations which we have studied from yesterday till now. So let's see what the function is and what we will look up. So the function will be function guess number. Wait, let me explain you somewhere else. One minute, please. Okay. One minute. Okay. Okay, guys. This will be our function, guess number, for running the our game. The main function which will be is function guess number. And we will create function guess number. Now see what we will do inside the function guess number. First, we will create a constant random. And constant is the, I have told you that we can take variables by taking either using let or const. We use let when the variable changes, and we use const when we want that the value of the variable should remain constant with the time. Anybody can't be able to change its value once declared. So in that case, we use const variable. And here we have used let number is equal to parse int. And see, here we have used parse int because we want the input should be in integer only. And next we have applied here while loop, and the check the situation. Is our number is not equal to random? If our number is not equal to random, so till the number which we have guessed in the prompt box, is not equal to random number, then till that time it will keep on asking you guess a number from 1 to 10, guess a number from 1 to 10, again and again, 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 keep on loop, it will asking you till the time you answered it correct. Once you answered it the correct, then what will happen? If the number is equal to random, then it will show you an alert box and show alert box. In the alert box, it will show you guessed the correct number. So, yes. And now we will apply this function in our script, that is using HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. We will make, or we can say we will develop this game. And once, let me more explain you this concept, how the function will work. See, in the const random, it is taking values from not 0 to 10, it is taking value from 1 to 10. So, now see, if const dot random operator has taken randomly taken value as maybe it has taken as the value 5 automatically by random. So this value is generated by random. And we have in the prompt box, we have inputted the value of our number as 3. Then what it will show? It will again ask you input. Then again, what you will do? You will again input the value as 2. Then again, it will check whether 2 is equal to 5. 2 is not equal to 5. Then again, what happens? This while situation meets that number is not equal to random. Then again, it will ask you. And now if you will input 5, then what happens? This condition will get false and this condition becomes true if number is equal to random. So our random number is also 5 and the number which we have inputted is also 5. And now what will happen? It will show you an alert box. You guessed the correct number. So I think so. JavaScript part will be clear to all of you that how to develop and make this function. Now let's see how to use it on our HTML page. So this HTML part is already written there. I will share you this video. In the HTML page, what is there? HTML is there, head is there, and the title we can write, guess the number. And after that, what we need to do? We need to print head, and in the center, what we have written the guess the number. Then in our div box, what we have written, we have inserted an image called numbers.gif, which is present here. We have inserted this image on our page. Then what we do, we have created one, forget this. We have created one button at the center. And in the button, we have applied CSS that block size will be 50 px. And the button name is click here. Now let's see our page. Yeah, it is here. You need to guess the number. And something is missing, I think so. It is showing, yeah, title is showing it correct. Yeah, body background color. So which color I should take? Any suggestion, guys, in the chat box?
Crimson.
Pratiksha, blue, red. Boys are saying blue, red, green, India red, as for nature, blue. And girls, what are you saying? Pink. And now it's girls' time. Any response from girls? Blue, 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 blue. Okay. All girls are responding to blue. Okay, let me take it as a blue. And saved it. Let me open this. Yes, we can take it as a blue or light. And yeah, if you want to change the color, yes, blue wins, guys. People are writing in the comment chat box, blue for the win. We can change the color like here with background color. And we can check here also which color you can keep using like this, checking like this, anti-echo white square, or this is something you can feel disco-like. And let me put something different. Design is also important part, I think so. Let me keep it as violet. Why should I listen to you guys? I'll keep it as violet, not blue, not black, not. So yeah, it is violet color. And when we click here, nothing is happening. You can see I'm clicking here. So yeah, our page, nothing responds. Let me refresh it. Now also it is not responding anything. Now for inserting the JavaScript part on our HTML page, what we do? Inside the body tag, we use one script tag and we need to close it also. So whatever we will write between this script tag, that will be treated as a part of the JavaScript. So if I will write here our function that I have explained you here, this function, if I will write there, let me copy it. Enter. Yeah. So this function name is guest number, and what we need to do, we need to run this function guest number on our HTML script. What we can do that we want, when we click this button, that function should run. So for doing that, we use one attribute called onClick equal to, and in the inverted commas, we put the function name. So the function name was guest. And yeah, JavaScript is case sensitive. Case sensitive means that lowercase and uppercase characters are treated differently. So if I will write here, number means lowercase number, then it will not run because here I have used capital N. So I need to write it here capital N only. Then I need to close it with curly braces. Now I have saved this file. Let's go to our page. Okay, I'm refreshing my page. Now let's click here. So yeah, what do you have seen? A prompt box appears here, guess a number from 1 to 10. So yeah, let me guess it 1. Okay. Okay, in the first time I guessed it, correct the number. Let's play again. Let me guess it 1. Okay, now see, it has appeared again. And Jaydeep, yes, I will share the code. After the class, the code will be shared to all of you. I have guessed it 1. See, I have written 1. Okay. So yeah, 1 is not correct. Now let me guess it 2. 2 is not also correct. So yeah, number should be between 1 to 10 only. 3 is also not correct. 4 is also not correct. 5 is also not correct. 6 is also not correct. 7, yeah. 7 was the right answer. You guessed the correct number. So I think so it's your time, guys. Let me play one time with you. Click here. So which number should I input? Guys in the chat box. 9. Ishika is saying 9. 5. 8. 5. 3. Wait, I will start from the first. Ishika said 9. Yeah, 9 is wrong. Sama is saying 6. 6 is also wrong. 9 is wrong. And Suhani is saying 4. 4 is also wrong. Soumyadeep, 5. So let me see 5 ones who are saying 5. Yeah, all the 5 ones who are saying 5, they won. 5 was correct. Okay, like this you can make any function. Like here I have made the function of guess number. You can make the addition of two numbers or subtraction or any mathematical complex things, or if you know any complex part of the coding from other languages, you can also use it here by converting, just playing some with scripts like changing the data type and all. You can easily make your own function in the JavaScript. So yeah. Wait, cancel. It is not canceling also. Okay, I think so. This is the end of our.
Is there any break option also, like if you want to stop the game in between?
Yeah, you can stop, but like where you want to stop. Means in this case, we don't need it actually.
Like if I want to create, like after the 3 guesses, you are not able to guess it the right, the game would end.
Yeah, after the 3 guesses, if you are not means going to correct the right answer, then the program should stop and it will show you that you lost the game. Yes, I'm correct. You want to do this thing now? So for doing this thing, yeah, you can use the break statement. Just you need to write break and then semicolon, just like any other languages. And anybody is having any other doubt related to this program?
Okay, Aniket Kakashi is saying that, can you show us how to do that?
Okay. What we can do? We can take a variable here. Let count is equal to 0. And one more situation here, like if count is greater than or equal to 3, then only this condition will run. Let me close this. And count plus. Please mute yourself. And yeah, it seems quite messy here in Notepad. I'll suggest you to use any Atom or Visual Studio for doing this if you are a beginner. If count is greater than, I've taken a variable, let count is equal to 0. If count is equal to 0, and what I have done, if if count is greater than equal to 3. Yes, wait, we don't need it here. Wait. Don't save. What we can do, we can just simply take a variable, count is equal to 0. After this, yes. let count is equal to zero, and after each situation we increase the count by one, and inside the situation we will check if count is equal to three. Alert, you lost. And one break. Let me save it. No count plus will be used here. So now what we are doing, we are first generating a number using the const, then we are taking a number. Then we have taken a variable, count is equal to zero, and in each situation, what we are doing, if count is equal to three, we are checking. Then it will show you an alert, you lost, and then a break statement will happen. Let us see. Wait, I have clicked cancel. Wait, let me open it. One, two, I guess the right answer. You can check in your console box also. Yeah, let me find it here. We have taken let count is equal to zero. If count is equal to three, and where we are increasing our count? Yeah, we need to increase our count value also, which we are not increasing here. In the while loop, where I have taken while loop. Yes, while loop is here. After this statement, guess a number from 1 to 10. Count plus plus. Actually, I was not increasing my value. Refresh the page. Now let me see again. We paste source. Here you can check your code. Just like I'm checking while condition is there. If count is equal to alert, you lost break, and it is increasing the number count plus plus. And number pass in. So yeah. Now one, two. Yeah. Oh, actually, I have guessed the right number. So now it will work. Because what I have done? Wait, let me show you again. In the while loop, what I have done, till the number is not equal to random, it counts the value. If it is not equal to random, so loop runs, if the loop runs three times and the condition meets that the count is equal to three, then it will show you alert box lost, and then there the break tag will come in use. And yeah, rest I will share the code with you. Yeah. Abhinav has also commented that you have not implemented the counter. Yeah, before I forgot to implement it. And yes, guys, anybody is having any doubt till now?
Okay, then. Thank you, Aniket, for giving us your time to teach in this event.
Wait,
so
yes, wait.
We are finally done with JavaScript. And from tomorrow, we can start with our introduction to React.js. So till now, if you have any more questions regarding today's class, the chat is all yours. You can also unmute your mic and ask your doubts.
So yeah. This was the function which we have used. You can use break tag also. And let me open chat. Yes, if you have any doubt, you can. And you can reach out to me on LinkedIn also. Yeah. Wait, what is... Anybody is having any doubt? No, Saksham, you don't need to install anything before joining tomorrow session. Okay, thank you guys. Let me stop sharing.
Okay, thank you Aniket, and thank you everyone. And sorry, so sorry for the interruption, Aniket. I guess Sandhani was having a network problem, so that's why.
So, no, not at all.
Okay. So if anyone has any doubts regarding anything, you can ask, or we can wrap up. Okay, I see no doubts. No. So tomorrow we are going to have a React session. So JavaScript is over.
And these files will be shared with you all, guys. Don't worry.
Okay, then I guess no doubts. All right.
Yes.
Thank you, Aniket. Thank you. Thank you very much for your valuable time for teaching us. And thank you to
everyone.
And if anyone is interested in joining our chapter, the links will be given in the comments, so you can go through it. And so I guess that's it. Thank you everyone, and be excited for tomorrow's event on React. Thank you guys. Bye bye.
Thank you everyone. Good night.
Good night, Jocelyn.